Firstly, thank you all for being here today. It's with a deep sense of sadness and loss that we gather today to provide you with some further information on the terrible incident that occurred late yesterday afternoon. Every single member of Victoria Police put themselves in harm's way every hour of every day in order to keep the rest of us safe. Their commitment to others, their professionalism, their courage is without question. Yesterday, we had a tragic reminder of the risks, the dangers, and the tragedy that that work can involve. On behalf of every single Victorian, I send the best wishes, the thoughts and prayers of all of us to the families of the four members of Victoria Police who died, keeping the rest of us safe. This is a terrible tragedy, made worse, of course, by the fact that our state is dealing with many other very significant challenges at the moment. I want to thank those members of police for the work that they are doing right now, the members of Victoria Police who are out there putting themselves in harm's way to make sure that the rest of us are safe. Their commitment, their professionalism, their service, we honour that today. The memories of those who we lost yesterday, their families, their friends, their colleagues. But today, I ask all Victorians to pause and honour every single member of Victoria Police for the work that they do, for the service that they offer. To live a life in the service of others is a deeply impressive thing. To lose your life in the service and protection of others is a tragedy. We honour those who have lost. We send our best wishes to their families. We send our best wishes and support to those who worked alongside them. And we, all of us, hopefully today can come together and spend just a moment thinking about every member of Victoria Police. And through that moment of quiet reflection, hopefully send our best wishes to every single member of Victoria Police. They do an amazing job, and we've been tragically reminded just how dangerous that job can be. I'm joined by the Chief Commissioner, who will provide you with an update, and Lisa is here as well, and we're happy to take any questions once Graham has provided the update.
Thanks, Premier, and thanks for those kind words. It certainly means a lot at Victoria Police to everyone, whether they're serving officers or our VPS staff at Victoria Police, that we have government support, and those kind words are heartfelt, and we thank you for them. Today we'd just like to take you through some further detail in relation to the collision on the Eastern Freeway last night. The matter is still under investigation, and accordingly, both the Homicide Squad and the Major Collision Investigation Unit are still looking at a whole range of aspects of it. So there is some detail I still won't be able to give you until interviews have been completed with some key people that need to be interviewed. And indeed, the scene at the Eastern Freeway is still an active crime scene, and it will be just for a few more hours yet, and we're hoping sometime through the middle of the day we'll be able to reopen that road, but it is still closed, and so there are a number of active leads and parts of this investigation that are underway. So there are some restrictions on what I can tell you this morning, and will be more fulsome as soon as we can be. In relation to our police members that have sacrificed their life last night, we're still in the process of notifying a couple of family members that are interstate, and therefore I can't give you their names immediately. We're preparing some profiles on those officers with obviously their career history and detailing their service to the community, and this morning, and we're hoping not too far away from now, we'll make that available to the community via the media so that more can be known about the great service of these four officers to our community. I believe it was about 4:50 last night on the inbound lane of the inbound stopping lane of the Eastern Freeway, just the city side of the Burke Road intersection. Two members of the what we call RPDAS, which is the Road Policing Drug and Alcohol Section, intercepted a 911 Porsche bearing the registration LLC001, Lima Lima Charlie 001, Porsche 911 that had been travelling at speed. We believe the officers at the time were alleging speed at about 140 kilometres an hour, and they have intercepted that vehicle in that lane and has pulled up in the emergency stopping lane on the left side of the freeway. A check of that vehicle and speaking to the driver, an oil fluid test was conducted, returned with positive results for some type of drug in the system, and that has prompted, obviously, with the speed and the vehicle, with the driver testing positive to impound the vehicle. Accordingly, the officers have called for support to do that from Highway Patrol, who are our experts at vehicle impounds. It's quite a detailed procedure you have to go through with impounds. And Highway Patrol vehicle attended a short time later to provide that support. That contained two police members in that vehicle. They had got out of their vehicle, and then it was only a short time later at around about 5:40 that a truck, a refrigerated semi, has come along that freeway. As it's still quite early in the investigation to describe exactly the movements of that vehicle until it can be better pieced together with video from the freeway and video cam videos from the officers. But the truck itself appears to have moved from one of the traffic lanes in the freeway into the emergency lane and has travelled a short distance in the emergency lane at around about 100 kilometres an hour, and has then slammed into the rear of the Highway Patrol vehicle, and that has caused a collision, which has then proceeded to include the vehicle from the RPDAS unit and then indeed the 911 Porsche itself. The Highway Patrol vehicle was spun from that accident across the freeway into the nature strip in the centre of the freeway, and the Porsche has wound up underneath the front of the truck. And police have immediately attended the scene, and as a number of Good Samaritans also attempted to render first aid, but unfortunately, as is now tragically known, our officers died at the scene. The driver of the truck has had a medical episode immediately following the accident, which seemed to involve him blacking out. Ambulances attended, obviously, to attend to the situation, and he's been conveyed for his health to the hospital. And at the moment, he is still in medical care, and we're hoping to get to interview him sometime today. We did do a warrant at his house last night. He is from a Cranbourne address, and we did a warrant through the night at his premises, and what was found at that premises is still the subject of ongoing investigation. In terms of the driver of the Porsche, he is someone that is known to us. He has an extensive criminal history involving a range of different offending backgrounds. 41-year-old man. I've been asked this morning not to name him. I understand that he is going to be attending one of our police stations this morning. Contact has been made with him through the night, and he's presenting himself this morning. So, again, the investigators have asked that I not name him until he presents himself, and I'll be making sure that that we don't do that. But as soon as we are able to, his identity will be known to you. We are pursuing with Facebook. There has been some images placed on Facebook that appear to have been taken by this individual at the scene before he has left the scene. And some of those photographs were circulating last night online. So I'd ask if anyone is finding photographs online not to further circulate them. And in fact, we're talking to Facebook this morning about removing those images from Facebook. There's a couple of other areas. We'll notify you later today in terms of both, as I said, the identity of the four officers, the identity of this Porsche driver, and of course the truck driver as well, who will be interviewed through the course of today. There's probably two other things I just want to mention this point before we take questions, or, and also invite the Minister to say a few words. We have in today got a lot of people who record dash cam footage, so if you have recorded any dash cam footage of this particular collision, we'd be grateful if you could make that available to us, so that that would assist the investigators in recreating what has happened last night. That can be made available to Crime Stoppers, 1-800-333-000. Please make that available if you have that footage, if you were in the area and you did record something that might be of interest. Secondly, we've been obviously very touched and grateful that people have been providing flowers and laying flowers at a number of locations this morning. We were certainly contacted overnight by a whole range of people wanting to express their sympathies to the families of the officers who have lost their lives, and we've been very grateful for that, as I say, but we are in an environment, as the Premier said, a very unusual environment with COVID-19. So we're looking to try and provide this morning details of some online opportunity that people can record record their condolences and their sympathies, and we'll be making sure that that is conveyed to the families rather than turning up in person and laying flowers. So we don't want to put anyone else's health at risk as a consequence of this. So please, if you were considering attending and laying flowers, we'd perhaps ask that, as grateful as we are for your condolences and sympathies, we'd ask that you do that in the online way that we'll hopefully be providing you details of shortly, that we spent some time last night trying to put that together. So we'll have some details on that also this morning. It is a tragic day for Victoria Police. Said last night, it's a tragic day for obviously the families of these officers, and we feel very deeply for them. The whole force is reeling this morning from what's occurred last night. It's an unprecedented event for us to lose so many officers in one event, in one very terrible collision on the freeway. And officers just doing their work, doing their job, doing a duty that is performed by officers many times a day across our state, and it is just a timely reminder of how tragic these police work can be at times, and indeed very unexpectedly at times. The whole police family is feeling that this morning, and will for many, many days to come. We're providing welfare to the officers, and providing welfare also to the many, many colleagues of our fallen officers as well. Thank you to the community for the expressions of support we've received so far. It always is something that is the primary motivator of any police officer, is to work for our community and to help others. And so at times like this, it's very much appreciated to know that the community cares about the fact that these officers have made such a sacrifice for their community. I'll ask the Minister just to say a couple of things and then take any questions.
Thank you. The Victorian Police Commissioner there, Graham Ashton. Speaking before that was Daniel Andrews, the Premier, and I mean, that's the part of the job that you don't want to do, isn't it? And I mean, I thought they both handled that so incredibly well, but I don't know what you say when we hear news like this, and I just think of all the police officers, not just in Victoria this morning, but all around this country, who have to go out again today and do that job. How do you do that, knowing that four of your own were lost in the way that they were late yesterday? I don't know.
You could feel the pain. You could feel his pain. You could see his pain etched all over his face. You could see the pain of Dan Andrews. And you think about the year they've had, of all the things they've had to deal with. And then on top of that, this. And somewhere across Melbourne 12 hours ago, they got the most heinous of calls. And there's real tragedy. And there's real grief in families across Melbourne this morning. And our thoughts, prayers and love are with them.